हेलो वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश क्लास लेट्स स्टडी विद प्रशांत कुमार। एज यूजुअल डोंट फॉरगेट टू लाइक सब्सक्राइब शेयर एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन। लेट्स स्टार्ट द फर्स्ट लेसन फ्रॉम हॉर्नबिल द पोर्ट्रेट ऑफ ए लेडी एंड इट्स राइटर इज खुशवंत सिंह। पोर्ट्रेट, पोर्ट्रेट मीन्स पेंटिंग और इमेज और डिस्क्रिप्शन। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द टेक्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू लेंड मी योर ईयर्स आईज एज वेल एज माइंड्स ऑल्सो। माई ग्रैंड मदर लाइक एवरीबडीज ग्रैंड मदर वॉज एन ओल्ड वुमेन। She had been old and wrinkled. Wrinkled means having wrinkles, that means creased, C-R-E-A-S-E-D, folded or rumpled, R-U-M-P-L-E. Wrinkled, wrinkled is adjective. Old and wrinkled. For the 20 years that I had known her, and the tense that is used here is past perfect tense. People said that she had once been young and pretty and had even had a husband, but that was hard to believe. People said that. The narrator, heard people say that she, here she refers to the grandmother of the author, had once been young and pretty and had even had a husband. So first had is used as helping verb and second had just to give the meaning got. So she had even had a husband. But that was hard to believe, that was difficult to believe for the writer, for the narrator. My grandfather's portrait, grandfather's portrait, my grandfather's sketch, painting, picture or image, hung with living being. We use hanged and we for non-living thing we use hung. For example, Kasab was hanged to death and the portrait is hung. So my grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece. Mantelpiece means mental self, S-H-E-L-F, or self above the fireplace in the drawing room. What is drawing room? A formal sitting room. So where was the portrait of the narrator's grandfather? His grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. He refers to the narrator's grandfather. He wore, W-O-R-E, wear, or worn. Simple past tense is used here. He wore a big turban. What is turban? A long length of material wound round, W-O-U-N-D, wound round head worn by generally sick men, M-E-N, that is turban. So he wore, narrator's grandfather wore, worn a big turban and loose fitting clothes. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest. Best part of his chest means most of the part of his chest, and he looked at least 100 years old. In the portrait, he looked 100 years old. He did not look the sort of a person who would have a wife or children. He looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. As for my grandmother being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. Let's infer The meaning of the thought was almost revolting. Let's infer the meaning. Generally, this question comes also understood. Which thought was revolting for the narrator and why? The thought that the author's grandmother was once young and beautiful is revolting on the author's mind because till now, the author, who is the grandson of this old lady, has seen his grandmother with wrinkled face that shows her old age and white hair. It was hard to believe that once his grandmother was young, pretty, and beautiful. She had been the same for the last 20 years the author had seen her. So he assumed that she had been the same all her life. Next, she often told us of the games she used to play as a child. She often told us, she here refers to the grandmother of the narrator, often told us she used to tell them. Then here the narrator and his other brothers and sisters. So she often told us of the games she used to play. Who used to play? Grandmother used to play as a child. As a child when she had been a child. That seemed quite absurd. Quite. Q-U-I-T-E. Quite means completely, whole. And Q-U-I-E-T, that is come. So that seemed quite absurd, completely absurd. And so question comes, what seemed quite absurd? What seemed quite absurd? That narrator's grandmother used to play games and she used to play as a child. That was totally absurd, quite absurd. That seemed quite absurd as far as the narrator's belief is concerned. That seemed quite absurd and undignified on her part, and we treated it like the fables of the prophet she used to tell us. And the narrator compared this like the fables. Fables, you know, my dear students, fables are short tales having animal characters, and in the end there must be a moral. So prophets means those who give message of God to men. So that seemed quite absurd. What seemed quite absurd? That grandmother used to play games. Understood. That seemed quite absurd for the narrator. That seemed quite absurd and undignified on her part. Her part refers to the author's grandmother's part. And we treated it like the fables. That means these are just only fables. These are possible only in fables, stories. Understood. Not practically. Such type of incidents for grandmother, the narrator could not imagine. Of the prophet, she used to tell us. She had always been short. Now the very stature, S-T-A-T-U-R-E, understood. Stature of grandmother is described. How did she look like? So she had always been short in height and fat and slightly bent also, stooping, S-T-O-O-P-I-N-G, stooping. Her face was a crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. So her face was a crisscross of wrinkles from this side to that side, wrinkled marks. Understood? That is creased marks, that folded marks running from everywhere to everywhere. That means everywhere to everywhere means from this side to that side, wherever you look at her. No, we were certain she had always been as we had known her. Old, so terribly old दैट सी कुड नॉट हैव ग्रोन ओल्डर, इससे ओल्डर और हो ही नहीं सकती है, एंड हैड स्टेड एट द सेम एज फॉर 20 ईयर्स, शी कुड नेवर हैव बीन प्रेटी बट सी वॉज ऑलवेज ब्यूटिफुल, सी हॉबल्ड अबाउट द हाउस इन स्पॉटलेस व्हाइट विथ वन हैंड रेस्टिंग ऑन हर वेस्ट टू बैलेंस हर स्टूप एंड द अदर टेलिंग द बीड्स ऑफ हर रोजरी, हर सिल्वर लॉक्स हर सिल्वर हेयर्स वायर स्कैटर्ड अनटाइडली ओवर हर पेल प्यूकर्ड फेस एंड हर लिप्स कॉन्स्टेंटली मूव्ड इन इनऑडिबल प्रेयर, इनऑडिबल प्रेयर द प्रेयर दैट कुड नॉट बी हर्ड. Yes, she was beautiful. She was like the winter landscape. Her beauty is compared with the winter landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. Let's explain this expression requires explanation. An expanse of pure white serenity. It refers to the calm, peaceful, and serene character and conduct of the author's grandmother. She is compared to the peaceful winter landscape in the mountains. Next paragraph. My grandmother and I were good friends. Subject verb agreement. Verb is agreed according to the subject. My grandmother and I were good friends. And syntax also. Here we cannot say that I and my grandmother. That is wrong as far as the rules of syntax are concerned. Because you should remember the rules of 2-3-1. पहले आएगा आपका second person, उसके बाद third person and last first person. We can't change this order. So my grandmother and I were good friends. My parents left me with her. My parents left. हम लोगों को छोड़ कर गए थे मुझे with her, with my grandmother, when they went to live in the city and we were continuously together. She used to wake me up in the morning and get me ready for school. She said her morning prayer in a monotonous sing-song while she bathed and dressed me in the hope that I would listen and get to know it by heart. I listened because I loved her voice, but I never bothered to learn it. Then she would fetch means go and bring, Jana and Lana, fetch my wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk, a tiny earthen inkpot, tiny small earthen inkpot that is made of earth, E-R-T-H, mud, that is mitti, earthen inkpot and a red pen. Tie them all in a bundle and hand it to me. So here it expresses what sort of pens did the grandmother take for her grandson. She used to wake him up in the morning and get him ready for school. She said her morning prayer in a monotonous sing-song while she bathed and dressed the narrator in the hope. With what hope did she sing in a loud voice? So that some notes of those songs could be remembered by the narrator. He could know it by heart. And narrator said, I listened because I loved her voice, but never bothered, I was not bothered at all to learn it. Then she would fetch my wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk, a tiny earthen ink pot and a red pen. She used to tie them all in a bundle and hand it to me. After a breakfast of a thick, stale chapati with a little butter and sugar spread on it, we went to school. Here, the narrator was accompanied by her, by his grandmother. She carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. It expresses her love for animals. She used to carry stale chapatis every day with her for the village dogs. Next para. My grandmother always went to school with me because the school was attached to the temple. So this is the reason that the narrator has given. The priest taught us the alphabet, letters, and the morning prayer, while the children sat in rows in lines on either side of the veranda, singing the alphabet, letters, or the prayer in a chorus, in a group. My grandmother sat inside reading the scriptures. She used to read the holy books, scriptures. When we had both finished, we would walk back together. This is the very important line. This time the village dogs would meet us at the temple door. They expectantly were waiting for the grandmother because she used to give chapatis to those dogs. They followed us to our home growling, howling and fighting with each other for the chapatis we threw to them. So let's stop here. We will meet in the next video. But before that, I would like to infer the word meaning. Okay, let's infer word meaning of some difficult words. Wrinkled. Wrinkled means having wrinkles, or you can say that creaked. Spelling is creased, C-R-E-A-C-D, creased, folded, understood. Next word, pretty. Pretty means attractive. Next word is hard, H-A-R-D. Hard means difficult. Next word is portrait. Portrait means painting ho sakta hai, aapka sketch ho sakta hai, picture ho sakta hai, image ho sakta hai, even description bhi ho sakta hai, because the portrait of a lady, the description of a lady, the image of a lady, the sketch of a lady, the painting of a lady. Next, mental peace. Mental peace, another name is mental self, S-H-E-L-F. So what is mental peace? Mental peace is a self, S-H-E-L-F, above a fireplace. Next word is drawing room. Drawing room is a formal sitting room. Next, turban, a man's headdress, or you can say a long length of material. The material is cloth, that is wound, W-O-U-N-D, wound round the head worn by generally sick men. S-I-K-H, not S-I-C-K, S-I-K-H, sick. Next, best part means most of the part. Next, sort of, kind. Next, lots. Lots mean many. Next word that comes before us, almost. Almost means nearly. Revolting, disgusting. Next word is seemed, appeared. Next word is quiet. Spelling mistake is there, my dear students. Q-U-I-T-E. Quiet means enough. Next, absurd, A-B-S-U-R-D. Here again, there is spelling mistake. Sorry for the unintentional mistake. A-B-S-U-R-D. Absurd means ridiculous. Next, undignified, disgraceful. Undignified means disgraceful. Next, treated. Treated means here considered. Fables, old stories.
next prophets, those who give the message of God to men. Next, slightly, a little. Bent, B-E-N-T, bent. Bent means stooping, S-T-O-O-P-I-N-G. Or you can say bending, B-E-N-D-I-N-G. My dear students, mistake is there. B-E-N-D-I-N-G hoga, bending downwards. Next, crisscross means lines crossing one another. Next, terribly, T-E-R-R-I-B-L-Y. Again, mistakes is there, spelling. Sorry for unintentional mistakes. T-E-R-R-I-B-L-Y. Terribly means too much. Next, stayed, remained, R-E-M-A-I-N-E-D. Next, hobbled about. Again, there is mistake. H-O-B-B-L-E-D, hobbled about. So, walked like a lame man. My dear students, you should just take those words from book and you should just infer the meaning here given. Next, spotless, without spots, white. Next, stoop. Stoop means bend of the body. Next, telling. Telling means counting. Beads. Beads means small small balls of wood. The rosary ka jo beads hota hai. Next, scattered, spread. Untidy, in disorder manner. Pale, P-A-L-E means faded color. Puckered, that is wrinkled. Next word, inaudible, which cannot be heard. Constantly, continuously. Landscape, scenery. Expanse, widespread. Serenity, tranquility, or clear and calm. Next word, contentment, satisfaction. Monotonous, unchanging. Sing song, singing in the same tone. Know it by heart, learn it by heart. Bothered, cared. Fetch, go and bring. Wooden slate, a wooden plate used for writing. Plastered, pasted. Tiny, very small. Earthen, made of earth. Stale, stale means not fresh. Rose means lines. Scriptures means holy books. Growling means grumbling, G-R-U-M-B-L-I-N-G. Thank you for you have listened to me with the greatest concentration. Thank you.